We never know where life will take us. Sometimes we think we were meant to do one thing and find ourselves doing another. The change may be a stark contrast from what we are used to doing, but you may find that the journey may be worth it.
So my name is Ellen Stein. I am retired and I live in Brooklyn, New York, and I'm 64 years old. Actually, I'm 2 months shy of 65.
It's not unheard of for athletes to cross train in sports. Take the Olympics, for example. There are many that participate in the triathlon, where they partake in running, swimming, and cycling. But what makes Ellen's journey unique is how she changed her sport completely.
So, I was a runner for 15 years. My dad was a very avid runner, so it was kind of like a way to get close to my dad. So I started running with my dad and started doing races. And I did that for 15 years. I was a very good runner. I was a ranked runner, believe it or not. My best mile time was 5 minutes and 48 seconds. And my best marathon time was 4 hours. So I did everything from the mile to the marathon. And I did that for 15 years. And I enjoyed it. But one day I entered the New York City Marathon and my application was rejected and they put me in what they had at that time was a lottery. So you either didn't get in or you did get in based on the lottery. So I just didn't feel like training for a race that I wasn't sure I was going to get into. And I just kind of decided that it was a sign from God to stop running and maybe find something else to do. So the local gym in my neighborhood was running the, you know, the standard New Year's resolution sale, like join now for the year, whatever, you know, everybody, all the New Year's resolutions, join in January. And they had a good sale on, and it was Gold's Gym at the time, and I joined. And a friend of mine was a bodybuilder, and he showed me how to use all the machines. And for about a year, I was, you know, working out like your standard person does in the gym, go to the gym, you know, and use all the machines. And then one day I saw a bunch of big guys with big bellies making a lot of noise in the corner, covered in powder and chalk and clanging and banging. And I was like, what is that? And they said, oh, that's powerlifting. And I said, oh, I want to learn how to do that. And at the time I had a bad, what I consider to be a bad back from years and years of running. And they had a massage therapist that worked at the gym at the time. And he said to me, oh, he says, it'll either kill you or cure you, the back. So I said, okay. So he taught me how to deadlift. And I was like, wow, this is cool. And within about 2 months, I was able to do 225, which, you know, is pretty respectable considering I just, you know. So then they said to me, wow, you know, you should try doing a powerlifting meet. And I'm like, okay, you know. And they said, well, there's a meet in Long Island in June. You know, you should train for it. So I'm like, okay. So in 1994 in June, I did my first powerlifting meet. I had no idea what I was doing. I had no clue how any of it worked. I just kind of got thrown into the fire. There were two women in the entire meet, which nowadays there's about 2,000 women in a big meet, like a nationals, a women's nationals. So I did the meet. I came in second, needless to say, out of two. But I squatted 220 pounds. I benched 126 pounds and I deadlifted 265 pounds. And I weighed 122 pounds at the time and I was 41. And I was hooked. I was like, this is really cool.
Before powerlifting, in Ellen's days before she was fully immersed in running, she had the great honor to be a part of history. To do something only a few people were ever able to do.
In 1984, when I was a mere slip of a girl, I got to run with the Olympic torch. And this is an actual replica of the Los Angeles. It says here somewhere, 1984. This was the LA Olympics, Summer Olympics, 1984. And I was a member of the, it was New York Telephone at the time, before it became Verizon. I was a member of the running team, so they let us run with the Olympic torch. So we ran from New Jersey to Ohio. It was, we'd run 8 miles a day in 4 mile segments. So you would run 4 miles and you'd hand off the flame to the next person. They'd run 4 miles, and you got to do that like twice a day. And they let us keep the torch. This was filled with propane, I think it was. And then the, you know, and I'd be like, I don't want to be like Michael Jackson. Don't set my hair on fire. But yeah, so you'd have to run with this thing. It's, you know, filled, when it's filled with propane, it's pretty heavy actually to go running 4 miles. Yeah, so we got to keep it.
Awesome.
And I've been trying to sell it on eBay because it's worth about $10,000. I've been seeing people selling theirs, but this was the year that Bruce Jenner won the gold medal too. So Bruce, AKA Caitlin. So anybody wants to buy this, it's for sale.
Ellen was encouraged to compete in the New York State Championships in Saratoga. And after winning the state championship and eventually the nationals in Florida, Ellen made her way to the World Championships in England.
I did my first World Championships in gear, and I think I squatted 319. And I don't know what I benched, but I deadlifted 341. And that was my first World Championships, which I won. And after that, it was like every year, states, nationals, worlds, states, nationals, worlds. And I got to go to all these different countries, South Africa, Argentina, Czech Republic, Canada, England. I don't even remember. I mean, that's pretty much the gist of it. And it was such an experience for me to be able to travel all over the world and compete in the sport that I really love. And of course, obviously, my lifting got better and better and better. But that's how it all started. And here I am, 24 years later, still lifting. Pretty funny because for the early part of my career, I was virtually uncoached at all. I didn't have a coach. I trained with a bunch of guys and I did whatever they did. So whatever they did, you know, it's follow the leader. And there was a girl in the neighborhood, a fellow Jewess. She was Jewish like me and older like me. And she kind of wrote me up a program, you know, but it was pretty much like do 5 sets of 5 and then go up 10 pounds every week. But that only works for so long because after a while you bottom out and you can't do the 5 anymore. So I played it by ear. My first, I would say 15 years of my career. How I was as successful as I was, given that I didn't know what I was doing. And then in 2009, I met Matt Gary, who is the owner of Supreme Sports Performance and Training in Maryland, Rockville, Maryland. And he was on the, he was helping coach the world team, or actually he was there to help his wife. Not really sure what the circumstances were under which we met, but he agreed to coach me. So for 6 years, he coached me. And that's when my lifting really took off because I had a program. I was training like you're supposed to. And then in 2015 or 16, I met Swede. And I just reached out to him and asked him if he would be willing to train me or coach me. And I said, it's going to be like nothing you've ever experienced before because I am not a young girl. I'm a master lifter. My needs are very different from your average client that you would have. And he said, I'm up for the task. And here we've been ever since. And I, you know, I'm on the gains train. I'm on the gains train.
Talk to strangers and always be polite. The good girls go to bed early and do what they're told.
Promise.
One day I may cross the line.
Ellen had to switch coaches because her previous coach had a serious injury. But even though she chose Sweet Burns as her current coach, let's just say she wasn't always a believer of his fifth set methodology.
Well, his program is called Fifth Set. We started doing it, I want to say, in October of 2015. In the beginning, I wasn't really convinced that it worked. I was very suspicious of a lot of this stuff. I didn't trust the process. It was completely opposite from anything that I had ever done before. But over the years that we've been together, it's proven to be very effective for me. And now I'm comfortable in it, and I've relaxed into it, and I trust the process. So it's working way better for me. You do 4 workouts over a 9-day period. So it's not like your standard week, a week of 7 days where you train, you know, Monday is chest and Wednesday is legs, and it's not like that. So the workouts go Workout one is bench, workout two is squat, workout three is bench assistance, and workout four is deadlift. And I train myself Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. So if I were to start the program, say Tuesday day would be bench, Thursday would be squat, Saturday would be bench assistance, and then the following Tuesday would be deadlift, and then it starts over again. But it teaches you to grind, it teaches you to push, you know, it's, sometimes I can be lazy. I've had times where I've walked into the squat bar and put the weight on my back, and then I'm like, nah, I put it back in the rack, I'm like, nah, I'm not doing this. So it teaches, it toughens you up a little bit. The assistance work is great. It's created a lot of hypertrophy in my body, which I never had before. And that's created a lot of growth in my muscles that help with my other lifts. But did you see the speed on that last one? I mean, granted, it was only 315, but that's how I have to lift. But that's how I have to approach everything that's on the bar, whether it's 5,000 pounds, you just lift it fast. So that's one of the benefits of this program, is that your technique speed lift, which is for me the deadlift, we focus on speed off the ground. Speed, speed, speed. So I never really hit like a heavy, heavy weight in training, but then I go to a meet and hit 100 pounds more. And in the beginning, I couldn't understand how that could happen. Like, how could my last workout be with 315 or 330 or whatever, and then I go to a meet and hit 420 something? Right. I didn't know how that, I thought I always have to lift heavy, but you don't. So, not on this program anyway.
It's impressive how Ellen has been in the game more than 20 years. But how did her body hold up in such a demanding sport for this long?
Well, certainly not my diet, because my eating sucks. I will be the first to admit I am not a good eater at all. I don't cook. I eat a lot of takeout. I really don't watch my macros. I'm fortunate enough to be 132 pounds, 365 days a year. My weight does not go up and down. A lot of women train at a heavier body weight and then diet down or water cut or whatever to make weight. I've been very fortunate that my weight is completely stable, and it's 132, 365 days a year. Even if I eat a pint of Ben and Jerry's, you know, every night before I go to bed, still the same. So I don't have to worry about that. I have, since I'm retired, I sleep, believe it or not, 12 hours a day. So my recovery is insane. I mean, not everybody can sleep till noon every day, but I've set up my life in such a way that I can, and I do, and that's why my recovery is much better than the person who has to do a 9-to-5 job, take care of kids, you know, do that kind of stuff. I have nothing but time. So, but my eating is definitely my biggest downfall. I do not eat properly at all.
Yeah. I think she should go for a 425.
You think she can do it?
Yeah, I think so. Sure.
There are many benefits to having an active lifestyle, but for Ellen, the benefits she sees is also what motivates her to keep going.
My dad is in an assisted living facility, and my sister and I go visit him every weekend. And when I see the people his age, sometimes even younger than him, he's 87, but there are some people that are in there, you know, that are younger than him. And they're in walkers, they can barely walk, they can barely get in and out of a chair, and their movement is just really, really gone. So, you know, I say thank God that I've led an active life, because I'm hoping that I'm gonna be like this till, well, they put me in a box, because I refuse to, you know, the end of movement is death. So I just don't wanna stop moving. I just have to keep lifting stuff, and thank God I've been injury free. And I don't have to deal with that, but you know, it breaks my heart to see people that are older that just can't move. And starting to be in that category, I want to be able to continue to be physically active until it's time to go.
Powerlifting is becoming an increasingly popular sport, and more people are jumping on board. For those who are interested, here's what you should do to get started.
Get a program. Get a coach. Do your research. You have to get a coach, and you have to get a program. and you have to follow said coach and said program. You can't just go from one thing to the other and think, well, this doesn't work, and it only this works, this doesn't work. You have to give everything time, 6 months to a year. Even if you don't have the money for a coach, there are plenty of templates online that you could look up and, you know, Google, whatever it is they do now, look them up and download. Ask your friends if there's someone in your gym that is a legend or that's, you know, a veteran that's been doing it for a long time. Pick their brain, you know, watch, focus on technique, forget about the heavyweight, it will come. Even if you're just doing the bar, focus on technique, technique, technique. Focus on form. Don't be in a hurry. Everything is all about time under the bar. Everybody's in a hurry. Everybody's in a hurry. And it's a journey. Appreciate the journey. I mean, you just have to get the experience, you know, and go to seminars. If you can find one in your neighborhood, go to a seminar, buy books, read books. There's plenty out there I could recommend. Obviously, Swede's book, Fifth Set, their ebooks. Starting Strength is an excellent book by Mark Ripito. There's just a lot of information out there. I mean, this is the information age, but surround yourself with people that know more than you and listen to what they tell you and don't be a millennial.
Not too many people can say they lived a life Ellen has. Even though she's a phenomenal athlete, she is known for so much more. Everyone she touches, she leaves a mark on them, whether it's interacting with people or caring for animals. Ellen is the true definition of a Wonder Woman, and her journey is still not done.
I want to continue to exceed the 1,000-pound total that I had last year. I'm already up to 1,007. I want to increase my raw lifting, my knee sleeve lifting. I'd like to get my bench to 2 plates. Would be really nice in my lifetime. That's about it. Stay relevant in today's world. I want to still be relevant. And I want to be admired and respected for the legend that I am, the living legend, the ageless Ellen Stein.
I do not drink enough water. I should be drinking a minimum a gallon a day. I'm lucky if I drink one bottle a day. I hate water. I just don't like it. Yes. So hydration is usually an issue for me because I tend to cramp up a lot, which isn't good. So, and as you get older, you also dry out. It's, you know, no big secret. After menopause, everything dries out. Cut.